Okay, we're gonna read too much glue. Oh no. Our art teacher says too much glue never dries. She reminds us glue raindrops, not puddles. And she warns me, Maddie, too much glue. But my dad and I love glue. At home, we make glue glasses, glue mustaches, and even glue bouncy balls. Mom is happy to help. So during our class, I find the fullest bottle of glue. I tip them up and over and squeeze, plop. Glue squishes from the orange tips and slops all over with sequins and googly eyes float in the gluey lake. Then it's time for the most important decoration. Geronimo! I belly flop onto the table and I roll around, letting the glue and everything else cover me. Time to go to the drying rack, I announce. But when I try to pull myself off of the table, I boing right back down. Too much glue, Maddie. Too much glue. This is bad. There's only half an hour until the end of school, and all I can do is lift my head, wave my hands, and wiggle my feet. The rest of me is stuck in this blocky, stucky mess. Can somebody help me? While my teacher breathes into a paper bag, Noah shouts, let's lasso him. Izzy, Noah, and Owen get to work. Soon, I'm roped up from all sides like a rodeo pony. But when they try to pull me out, snap, the lassos break, leaving colorful octopus tentacles everywhere. The glue is too strong, and now I'm clingy, stringy, blocky, stucky mess. Don't worry, Maddie. We know what to do. Is that a tow truck? I asked as they wheel the contraption over and stick the plastic hook into my glue. My friends pull one way, and then the glue pulls the other. Creak, click, until kaboom! The tow truck explodes, and the plastic bricks rain all over the room. Now I'm a clicky, bricky, clicky, stringy, blocky, stucky mess. The school nurse bursts in and checks my temperature. 98.6, sorry. No fever. I can't send you home early. She dabs and pats me like I'm spilled juice. But the more that she blots, the more the glue spreads. Soon, I'm a melted mummy, clicky, bricky, clingy, stringy, blucky, sucky mess. Then the principal comes in. He takes one look at me, sticks a note on my belly, and leaves. Seeing my teacher huffing and puffing like the train gives me a great idea. I whisper it to Haley and Owen. The final bell rings and everyone freezes, except for Owen and Haley. It's as big as one we could make. They shout, flapping the paper fan at me. Then, just as I'm thinking, I'll be a note on my tummy, melted mummy, clicky, bricky, clingy, stringy, lucky, stucky glue boy for the rest of my life, my plan works. Something my teacher said could never happen, happened. The glue dried, but I'm still stuck. And now I hear footsteps. The door starts to open. My father and some other carpool parents walk in. Dad comes closer and inspects me. Then he peels me off the table, glue, yarn, bricks, and all. He spins me around, and no one makes a sound. Then Dad smiles. Maddie, you're a masterpiece. He holds up for everyone to admire. My friends cheer. The car ride home is interesting. Mom is speechless when Dad brings me into the house, but he knows what to do. Well, kiddo, some beautiful things only happen once, and this is one of those things. He gently grips the dry glue in front of my neck, behind my collar, and he peels me open like a banana. Now it's Dad's turn to glue. He seals up the side of me, shaped work of art. I bet it would take all the glue in the art room to make you shaped work of art, Dad. Dad laughs. Then he glues a big magnet on the back of my project and he hangs it on the fridge. During dinner, we sneak peeks at my masterpiece. Then, after dinner, we take the principal's note very seriously. The principal's note says, from the desk of Elmer G. Stuckey, please encourage Matty to use tape instead of glue.